Welcome to Daily Zohar. The Zohar on Parashat Pinchas says, "Vayidaber Adonai el Moshe lemor, Pinchas ben Elazar." And of course, we're talking about where HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives Pinchas the Kehunat Olam. This shiur is dedicated to Ilui Nishmat Yona Dalia Bat Esther v'Rabbi Shalom Dar, and to the Hatzlacha of Fegel Sarah Bat Reuven Leib. So on that statement, on that pasuk, Rabbi Elazar patach v'amar. Rabbi Elazar said, "Shma beni musar avicha ve'al titosh Torah timecha." Listen, my son, to what your father tells you. He's the way he rebukes you. Ve'al titosh Torah timecha, and do not desert what your mother taught you. Shma beni musar avicha. What does it refer to according to Rabbi Elazar? Zehu HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Avicha refers to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Ve'al titosh Torat imecha, and don't desert the Torah of your mother. Zoi Knesset Israel. That's the body that's called Knesset Israel. Ma'u Musar Avicha. What does it mean, Musar Avicha? Musar, from two different words. Musar ma'asher limsor, to hand over. V'mishum le'yaser, something of, I wouldn't say to torture, but you know, somebody tells you, you're not doing something right, so, you know, fix it. That's called musar. So what is musar avicha? That is the Torah. She'yesh ba'kama tochachot. HaKadosh Baruch Hu rebukes us there many times. Kama onashim, many punishments. When it says musar avicha, musar Hashem bini al timas ve'al takutz betochacho, don't say I heard enough. It's like, or don't say I had enough of this already. Mishum shekol mi she'osek b'Torah ba'olam hazeh, whoever learns Torah in this world, zoche, will merit she'yiftechu lo kama she'arim, many gates will be open to him. Kama orot la'olam ahu, many lights in the world to come. When we depart from this world, the Kabbalah says that there are certain gates and certain chambers. And from chamber to chamber, on any chamber, there is a malach ha-shomer, there's a guarding angel that you need to give an account to, a report to, for him to open the gate for you to enter to that chamber, up and up and up. To a person who learns Torah, the password is the Torah that he learned. If you learn Torah ba'olam hazeh, the doors will be open and you're going to walk as one chamber. You see, the doors will be open and you'll be able to walk through them, and they'll open up by themselves. The Torah will be the password. You know, like they have in the movies, you know, you go into the thing, they scan the thing, you put the eye, put the hand, psst, opens up. Same thing here is the Torah. The Torah does this for you. You don't even have to do anything. It will open up by itself. And what does it mean, orot, lights? We know the paths of this world. You know, you go here, you go there. We have our own world GPS. But in the world to come, we don't know how the spiritual work is about. And it might be a little bit of a darkness to us. We don't know. The Torah will come and would prevent you, provide you with the lights, so you'll know the paths you'll be able to walk. So not only the gates will be open, Michael, the lights will shine also for you to walk. Now you gotta work. Don't sleep. Al ken, therefore, b'sha'a she'niftar min ha'olam, a person dies and departs. We call niftar min ha'olam. Niftar means he got rid of this world. Baruch shepetaranu. Thank God got rid me from this, right? Shepetaranu niftar min ha'olam, from this world. Ha'torah makdima lefanav ve'olechet lekol shomrei ha'shearim. The Torah walks ahead of him, as we just said, and goes to all the angels and to the guards in the, and they open the door for you.
Easy pass.
And that's, you know what, that's exactly it. It's the easy pass. Right? It's the easy pass. He comes in and the door's opened up. Now, you need some power behind this. This is your Torah. Don't tell me it's not important to you, or don't tell me you find more important things to do than to learn Torah. Don't tell me that there's something with a higher priority to learn Torah. The only priority that you have, come join us. The only priority that you have that you allow to stop learning Torah is what? To save somebody's life. Why? So he could learn Torah. It's amazing. If this is the most important thing in our lives, do we make it the most important thing? We say it. Do we really mean it? Do we really do it? And I told you this a million times. It is the time in which you're going to set for your Torah. A part of your Torah is to be able to get up in the morning and pray. Imagine how would a father would feel. And you're going to tell him, oh yeah, I love your daughter so very much. You're marrying your father-in-law. Go to him, say, oh, I married you very much. He says, okay, good, let's sit down and talk a little bit. No, I don't want to talk to you. I'm too busy for you. For you, I don't have time. But, oh, I love your daughter. It'll be very, very hard to persuade a person that you really love his daughter when you reject a part of him. If you rejected him, probably you reject something about his daughter as well, because he's the father. So you have to be koveh itim la Torah. Rabotai, this is not for nothing. This is your ticket la'olam haba. And if you think that everybody is guaranteed to make it, you're wrong. You have to earn the ticket. And here we say, it's not about, you know, it is easy for me to learn. Oh, he's so much smarter than I am. He's so much talented than I am. He can learn better than I can. So therefore, let them learn, you know, I can. It has nothing to do in this world with the achievement. It has to do with your action, with your effort. The effort is what counts. Hama'aseh chashuv. It's the difference between emunah and ma'aseh. Yes, I believe the Torah is important. I believe the Torah is important. But there's no action. I don't do anything for it. It will be very hard for you to believe, to persuade anybody. Do you really believe that if it's so important to you, why don't you learn? So in this world, it's your effort that counts. As the Gemara says, Lefum tza'ara agra. The greater the suffering, the greater the reward. Suffering doesn't mean you have to learn and suffer. It's hard for you to learn. It's hard. It's easy for you. You got used to YouTube. You want to learn YouTube. You want to see pranks on YouTube. So I don't understand, again, why anybody would watch pranks on YouTube. I mean, why do you watch pranks? Or what do you want to see? Why do you laugh at other people's misery? It's beyond me. But that's a different thing altogether. The only thing that you could do is, okay, so you were doing the Torah anytime, you're watching Torah online. But still, it'll be more important for you to come here. You need to come and learn. You need to make the effort to learn. Yes, if you're watching video, Torah video is much better than to watch, I don't know, Shakira on video. But you need to come here, the effort to get out of bed. You don't want to make the effort to get out in the morning on time. You need to, we have a meeting, we have learning here at 6 o'clock in the morning. Don't tell me that Torah is important to you if you never made an effort to come here on time. And we learn here till 1 o'clock and then from 8 to 10 at night. You need to make an effort to come. You have to make an action. So this is what the Torah is going to open the doors for you in Olam Haba, the gates. You don't have. You know how scary it is to stand in front of an angel? Angels are not a pleasant sight. You know, those like, Christian take on Greek gods and, you know, angels, a little cupid, like darling like this, you know, all pink, puffy like this, flying with little wings like this, you know, like Walt Disney style. These angels are scary creatures. Scary creatures. eyes all over. This is not a pleasant sight. Because in that world, it's not about looks. It's about action. So you stand in front of a thing like this, what are you going to say now? Don't worry, we understand it's difficult. The Torah will open the door for you. The Torah says, don't worry, he's with me. He's with me. And every door will open. And the more you learn, more doors will open. More doors will open. More doors will open until you get to the highest chamber of all. And in those chambers also there are levels. And if you learn with tremendous dedication, it was hard for you, you get all the way up to Kisei HaKavod, under the throne of glory. Do you understand what it is? I want to see you all. Forget about going to school, the most of us fail in that. I want to see you now making money and making your Torah priority over your money. I challenge you. You want to get to Olam Haba. You know, we all know, whether we want to acknowledge this out loud or we don't want to acknowledge this out loud, we all know that there is a God out there and one way we're going to die. We know that. But how much are we willing to acknowledge that? We all know this. Are you really willing to do that? One day you're going to say, no, that's, I need to come and learn, I'm coming to learn. I can give 2 hours of learning, that's all I can. I come to learn from 10 to 12. I come to learn from 9 to 11. From 8 to 9. From 8 to 10. Whatever it is. But this is the time I have to learn. I don't care about anything. When you're going to do that, if it's hard for you, this is how you get the reward. Not for it was, did I, yes, there is a reward on understanding. But the reward is, first of all, how much you would willing to put up to really show it's hard for me. I right now can go and make money. And I'm saying, no, I'm choosing to learn Torah over. This is your reward. Yes, you need to understand. Yes, you come here to learn. You're not come here to talk about, Shimon Peres or Bill Clinton or whatever in the world you want to talk about. But you came here to learn. It was hard for you. You had a struggle now. When you're going to college, you need to set your... Hello? You need to set your priorities according to the yeshiva, according to the Torah. Not yeshiva, according to the schedule of school. This is how difficult you're going to struggle on this. Come. On this difficulty of how much you're going to struggle, you're going to make an effort to find it. You're going to go to New Jersey to pick up a course. It's not going to come into conflict with the Torah. That's your reward. But when you take the Torah, oh yeah, it's precious, and you toss it out. Don't tell me it's precious. Just toss it out of the window. Because this is going to open the doors for you. You can get by your effort all the way up to Kisei HaKavod, all the way up to the highest of highs. Based on the effort, based on how hard it was for you to make the time and learn. That you were tired, and it was hot, and it was humid, or it was cold, and you said, no, I gotta learn. And guess what is going to happen to you? The day that you decide to come to learn, every angel is going to be out in a car and they're going to drive like grandmas in Florida and you're going to be stuck in the traffic from here to Timbuktu and you're going to say the exit, ooh, I can just make a turn and I can go back home and Baruch Shepetaranu. I'm going to come to yeshiva now, it's going to be what? I'm going to spend here 2 hours, I'm going to say hello, sit down 5 minutes and go. Yes, that's what I'm going, I'm not going to turn back. I made a decision to come and learn. And you think you're going to happen to you as soon as you say that, the road will open up. No, it's going to be more traffic. And you're going to come home, you're going to come to yeshiva, Rabbi Hananiah, we finished. Yes, okay, I came. That was my effort to come. That was your test. Not to turn around because you see the exit. The other side, there's no one. The exit is just coming on the ramp. The exit is empty. All I got to do is go like this. going back. No, I made a decision to come to learn. This is your reward. Your reward is dependent on how hard it is for you. The reward is not if you are able to finish Shas and you know and all. It's easy, easy, easy. That's not a trick. How hard it is. How much you don't understand and you still want to come here and learn. How much you know, guys are cruising through the Gemara. They're reading Aramaic, Ivri, Deli, Dela, Dela, Delay, you know. In and out. And you are still, you cannot even make the punctuations the right way. You can't tell between a comma, parentheses, and I don't know. But you still come and learn, and you, that is exactly what we are looking for. We are looking for effort. The result does not make a difference. Yes, it will be nice to learn, to know, but it's not important. That is Musar Avicha. And then the Torah, when it comes to Olam Haba, the Torah will announce and it will say, Pitchu Hashe'arim, open the gates, Ve'yavo Goy Tzadik, and this righteous person is going to come. The Torah speaks for you. You don't have to come like a ani, like a bang on the door, hello, is there anybody out there? Hello, is there anybody in there? It's going to open up. Open the gates. Like when a king comes in. And who can say no to the Torah? Especially in Olam HaEmet. Who can say no to the Torah? The Torah will come and open the gate. Not only he says, open the gates. He says, Hatkinu kiseh. Prepare a chair, a seat to this individual. And then you get a title. Eved HaMelech, the slave of the king. You know what you need to do to get the title of being slave of God? The only person who was rewarded with that title was Moshe Rabbeinu. If you made your effort, you will be entitled to be called Evan Hashed, the slave of God. Ki ein simcha la kadosh baruch hu. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the only joy that he has, Ela b'mi she'osek b'Torah. Only for those who learn the Torah, he's happy with him. Not the one who sleeps in bed until 9 o'clock. It's too hard for me to get up, Rabbi. Oh, please. What are you going to say? I gave you life. I gave you alarm clock. You slept? Ela mi she'osek b'Torah. Kadosh Baruch Hu rejoice in that. Ki kol ha-tzadikim shebegan Eden makshivim lekolo v'Kadosh Baruch Hu nimtza b'neihem. All the righteous people in Gan Eden will come and will listen to your voice. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu will sit there among them and would listen to you for what you had to say. So you think that you learned and nothing entered in your head. You say, well, listen, I've been learning for 20 years. I still have a hard time learning the Gemara. Look at this kid. He's not even 11th grade. He cruises to the Gemara. Don't worry. Because the Torah is like an energy. There's no wasted energy. You're going to come to Shamayim, and everything that you learned this year, I mean in this world, whether you understood it or not, will come and will speak and it will come out of your mouth. There is no waste in Torah. And then you're going to be talking and you're going to say, holy smoke, that's me saying that. As it sometimes will happen you here, you would learn and you would learn and all of a sudden you feel this idea or concept that somebody asks you and you have the answer and he says, where does this answer come from? It will be the same thing there. That's why you need to learn. It's like a pit, like a reservoir, that it's sealed. Everything that you learn is going to stay with you here. This is why it's important to fulfill your life and to fill your life with positive words, with words of Torah around you all the time. Why are you going to go to Shamayim? Imagine you're going to go there. You did some good deed. You're going to come to Shamayim and say, okay, Bechavod Ya'amod Na'a Plonim, Mr. So-and-so, give us Dvar Torah. So all the tzaddikim are there. All the righteous people. The Rambam and the Ramban and the Rashba and the Rivash and everybody. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu right there. And Moshe Rabbeinu, HaKadosh Baruch Hu right there. And why are you going to say that these hips don't lie? Why are you going to say that? I don't understand. What are you going to say is everything that you learned here today. You don't believe in that. You don't believe in Olam Haba. Everybody does. Even the atheist believe in Olam Haba. Put an atheist in a foxhole, as they say, there are no atheists in a foxhole. But put an atheist in with a bullets and say, God, if you're there, give me a sign. He's already talking to him. Everybody believes in God. So therefore, and it says, because it says, Hayushevet Baginim, he who sits in the Shekhinah, who sits in the garden, Ezegan, Gan Eden, Chavirim, the friends, Chavirim Ad Tzadikim, Makshivim Lekolech Hashmeini. Listen, let me rejoice on the words that the Neshama is going to say in Olam Haba. Let me rejoice on this, the words of Torah. Rabbi Shimon Amar, Hamikra Hazeh, that Pasuk, יש בו סוד החוכמה היושבת בגנים. It's a great secret into that. And who is this who sits in the ganim, in the gardens? Zoi Knesset Israel. It is that house of Israel that is called Hamalchut, kingship. שהיא בגלות עם ישראל. Knesset Israel, the Shechina, went to galut עם עם ישראל together. It's not alone, so we're never alone. והולכת עמהם בצרתם, and walks with them in the hard time. חברים מקשיבים לקולך, the friends listen to your voice. What voice? לכל התשבחות שלך בגלות, to your voices of praises when you praise God in exile. השמיני, and it says השמיני, as it says, הרני את מראיך, השמיני את קולך. Let me see your beauty, let me hear your voice. השמיני הקול של אלו, who are those? What call are we talking about? החברים העוסקים בתורה. The korban, the smell, the fragrance that was taken away from us at the time of Beit HaMikdash is substituted today with the voice of the people who learn Torah. Ki en shevach lifanai keilu ha'oskim b'Torah. The greater praise for God is the voice of those who learn the Torah. So you can build shuls and you can build buildings and you could build mausoleums. And it is not important. At this world, at this time, right now, the most important thing is the voice of Torah. You could build a building and spend $3 million in it. Is there a voice of Torah in it, or there isn't? Don't judge a place by how much it cost. Judge a place by how much learning there is in it. Because this is the Shevach of HaKadosh Baruch Hu in this world. So let's stop here. And I wish that we were all, and all of us, should make HaKadosh Baruch Hu very proud of us, Ba'olam Hazeh Ba'olam Haba. Yehi Ratzon, that we will fill this place, and any place that we will be in, Bekol Torah, Kol Sason Vekol Simcha. It's not Kol Sason Vekol Simcha, Ki En Sason, ואין שמחה אלא בשמחת התורה. So don't say כל ששון וכל שמחה. כל תורה. כל תורה. And that call of Torah, that voice of Torah that we're going to learn here and share would stand us all in Olam Haba and will open the gates and we will see and will remove any kind of curtains that might separate between us and HaKadosh Baruch Hu, our Father in Heaven. I would like to also encourage you to send us feedback and email at rabbigaon@gmail.com, and if you would like to participate and help us out with a donation, you can go to our website www.yeshivaetzion.com, and there is a PayPal there. We would love to hear from you and would appreciate your kind support. Thank you.